Sure, so basically just finish through with that area. And now we gotta work with Seth though again. This is where we get our life upgrade. So this mission.
Oh, it's like that, is it? Huh? Not talking to Seth today? Oh, the old silent treatment. Oh, whoa, whoo-hoo. That's quite a stench.
Hey, Seth. Seth, come back here.
Oh, hey, partner. I was just looking for you.
Looking for me? What? Over there?
How you doing?
I'm good.
Well, see you later, partner.
Where you going, partner?
Nowhere.
Okay. Nowhere wouldn't happen to be where that thing you're looking for is kept, would it?
No, sir. No, sir.
Come on, partner.
Okay, I was just fooling. Partner, you know, the thought of that treasure does funny things to me. According to the map, it's somewhere in that big abandoned house.
Yes, so it's in there. Basically, need to help him out, and we're going to be doing fighting, but this is the part that gets annoying.
It's an ambush! Thanks for all the hard work, Seth!
Did you see these fellas?
See, you have to guard him there. This is where we get our life upgrade, but it can be extremely difficult. So let's kill them all. Oh, we're almost dead. Come on. Die. Oh, don't wake him up. Don't wake him up, dude. No. Before it gets irritating, gotta get all the way back there. Oh no, assholes. Damn it. No. Come on. Fuck. Fuck, no. Shit. No. I can't see. No. 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 John. Wait. How far do we have to... assholes. How far do we have to start back... Oh, yes. Oh, no. Back here. Yes, of course we have to start back here. All the way back here. And of course, one of the hardest sections in the game. You don't even get a life upgrade until afterwards. Not before, nope. After. Chester appear a lot.
Damn, nation! Don't let him get my treasure, mister!
I wasn't going to, son. You can relax. Saw a shotgun. Gonna be using that too. Helps very disturbing them. Helps to terminate them. Both saw a shotgun and the Winchester appear. Help to terminate people in this area. Need to go to your house and search through. This part can also be real annoying.
I can't lose that treasure. Not now. You gotta help me.
It's locked. Let's try around the back.
Go, basically go through this area right here.
You gotta go now!
We're in luck.
Except then you have to fight people. It can be hard because this area is dark, so I'm probably going to be causing a lot to give light.
Troublemaker!
Wait, did I just walk? Oh, I did. I walked right past him.
You want more?
Basically, gotta find a treasure. This part can be really irritating. I can sort of see him, but... Oh, it's not helping here. Okay, I can kind of see him, but... Oh, I got holes in my back. About it. Where are we good, Trip? We're good. Okay, there. We did it! Well, we're not done with the mission, but at least we're finished with that annoyingly retarded section. So we gotta. This part isn't as difficult. There are you. Went it through.
Think you can just walk
curious,
in
and he got a face full.
There it is.
Have you got it? Come here. Let me see.
Carry on, we're good.
Of this very long, long tunnel. Seth's gonna be rich after all these years. Woo-hoo-hoo! It's silk sheets and Parisian whores from now on, mister. What the goddamn hell is this? A glass eye.
I'm sure whoever that belonged to treasured it very much.
Those stupid liars. Those stupid chicken shit maps. Making a damn fool of me. A glass eye! It's a glass eye!
Stop with the tears and help me with Williamson's gang. And you can come up with another excuse to go exhume one of your old friends.
Hunting dead man's treasure ain't done me no favors. Sure. Sure. I'm ready for the living. I'll see you and Mr. West Dickens over at Fort Mercer when you gentlemen is ready.
Okay, and that's it. Okay, and there we got our life upgrade. It's one hit more, but still. Platforming here in this part, just like we did at the beginning of the mission. $30,000 more till the next life upgrade, huh? Probably be able to get it. Hopefully I will. Still need more for the Buffalo Rifle, if I ever want to get that. Which was Dickens. Hopefully, I'll do another mission with him. And let's throw off it. I'll cut to it later. Okay, and we're at Ridgewood Farm now. So let's go. Stop here for this mission. Letter sheets and other proud Americans. West Dickens.
Mr. Marston, how are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend, Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead. Yes, interesting fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. West Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on professional exhumers. But did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy, your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull, feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business. And this being America, that lubricant with which we concern ourselves is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon. Extra hands. And I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? No. The sport of kings. Racing, my friend. The sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating degenerate like myself can prosper. Come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive. Now, sir, to Gaptooth Breach.
Okay, so now we're going to Gaptooth Breach. And I'll skip to the destination. Okay, so it's basically a horse racing mission. It can get irritating though. They haven't hit me throughout the entire game, and they won't, or else I will destroy a species. Well, kind of already am though. I'll try and make the tiger on me. Actually, John's a species known as a human. I don't know, I always thought it was some weird mix of like an ape and a rabbit. Oh no.
But for you newcomers, oh, here's a bear.
Shit, we got the ugly horse.
Keep your manners and let the fester cart pass.
Crap, this horse is so ugly. Damn it.
Y'all can get to running each other off the road like always.
Damn, this horse is just so ugly.
Ready. Set. Go.
Yeah, I basically want to get to in first place.
Damn horse! This is gonna be easy! Damn
here, going up to there. and make that shortcut there. Basically make a circle. By the way, that's actually, that area we just went to is the westernmost section of the game. Yeah, that's kind of cool. Now we're about good. To the flag. Finish line. There, we made it.
Hell of a race, mister. I'll take care of this part, Mr. West.
Now we go back to West Dickens.
I suggest we beat a hasty retreat. Right, best remover.
Go over to skip to destination.
Sir, well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old man.
Oh, patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish?
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow. He usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better?
Okay, so basically gonna go see West Dickens, where he is. In Plainview, I think. Yes, Plainview. Okay, so I will cut to it. Okay, and we're about there. Start the mission. View. Can a swindler change his spots?
Mr. Marston, sir, John Marston. Mr. Marston, don't be so childish. Come on, sir, I implore you. Okay, so I made a few innocent mistakes when last we met. But my plan is still sound. Together we can conquer, if not the world, then certainly Bill Williamson.
But first, you need me to do you a favor?
You read my mind. I can only deduce you've been taking my tonic, sir, as instructed. It can give the most ordinary of intelligences a remarkable insight.
I'll give you insight. I'll show you what your guts look like.
Please, sir, this show of petulance is nothing short of embarrassing. Think for a moment, sir. Think.
I'm thinking about how much of my time you're wasting.
Sir, I am about to do something
which I greatly discourage in all wise and rational men. A selfless act for you. But, sir, before I act selflessly, allow me to act selfishly and sell some of my wares.
Fair enough.
Oh, good, sir. Come, and let's go visit some of our fine friends in the other oil business we have here in Plainview. These men need all the help they can get.
Okay, we're basically just gonna go in with the crowd.
Ladies and gentlemen, gather round, gather round.
Oh, a tumbleweed. What do you know?
Hardworking souls of Plainview, do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic, or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article which cures headache, neuralgia, toothache, earache, backache.
Well, this man is a fucking charlatan. He just got done swindling us down at Cho Springs with this song and dance.
I say we tar and feather him right now.
I say we shoot the bastard.
I think it's time we take our business elsewhere. I apologize if science is not your forte. Good day, one and all.
You're now basically need to offend him. Stuff. Don't worry about Kate. Don't worry about collecting your bars, because if you wait too long, he'll eventually dry off. No worry. Helping him. This is when we really start to miss the gravity wheels and gravity boots. Gravity shoes. This is mega boots and mega wheels. Mega shoes make you go half your speed on this. And there is. Look who's back, the plumber. They should basically go shoot him down and put him this way.
Yes! You got him! One less moron to worry about!
And, make sure mounts, not in the warrior, because if you can't actually kill him, if he's running by, if he's caught in the crossfire, he can be killed.
Fine shot, my boy!
And just go,
That's it.
Just go kill him.
Sure is lucky you came along. You did. Lucky for who?
Curso. God, get. Should be a TNT bro or something, or we could just shoot that way. Probably think of a different mission. Apparently I wasn't. It was a TNT bro.
Let's push on Cueva Seca. Moderation. What do these numbskulls expect? Miracles?
Cueva Seca's up there. It's gonna be a while,
that's
okay.
That's not what you've been promising them. Keep your eye out, John. For a man of the people, you sure ain't very popular.
I am up against the weight of previous ignorance, my boy.
Apparently, he wasn't driving it correctly.
Maybe you need to think about a change of career.
I will never give up on science, John.
These people are
harbor such bitterness.
Well, I ain't surprised. That tonic I drank at Ridgewood went through me like a dose of salt.
Curse, so it's a good game. Hit Joe here. Going to should be too farther. And
well done.
Almost there. Okay.
Well, that was a little hairy. Thank you, my dear boy. You saved the day again.
It always impresses me with the speed with which a group of men can turn from passive sheep into murderous wolves.
I'm impressed with how you nearly got us killed back there.
Yes, perhaps we should shelve the tonics business for a period.
Let's say we try our hand at racing again. There's a meet at Rathskeller.
You're trying my patience, Mr. West Dickens.
Well, I'm sorry, dear boy, but I'm only an aging vendor of exotic elixirs, not the bloody U.S. Cavalry. Forgive me if matters take some time to prepare.
Sure, so you basically got this, so help us suck up dollars and stuff. It's efficient in some ways. Still gonna need more for my life upgrade. Still have to go through a few more times if I want to get the Springfield rifle. Okay, sport of sheets and lawyers.
Mr. West Dickens!
It's Cuervas Seca.
Ah, Mr. Marston! How wonderful to see you, sir. How wonderful.
Are we ready then?
Yes, sir. Nearly, sir. Barely, nearly, sir. I just need some cash to get some extra hardware fitted to my old Trojan horse here.
You what?
Never mind, sir. I can only presume that you have not enjoyed the benefits of a classical education, so I will not take umbrage if some of my illusions sail over your head, sir.
I won't pretend to understand you, but I will endeavor to make you understand me. Either we do this right now, or I put a bullet in you and get on with my day.
Please, I knew you were a violent man, Mr. Marston, but I did not think you were a stupid one. We need money to outfit my carriage, to turn a simple tradesman's vehicle into something more subterfuge. And I'm about to tell you how we are going to gain said cash. Now I know that you ride very well. So come, sir, to Rathskeller Fork.